The Fisheries and Aquaculture Minister nominee, Mavis Hawakumsen, appeared before the committee first. She was confronted with the issues regarding a shooting incident involving her during the 2020 voters registration exercise.
It was an unfortunate incident, Mr. Chairman, which I wish it never happened on that day. And I don't also pray that it ever happens again in the history of our politics in Ghana. Mr. Chairman, I want to seize this opportunity to also apologize to the people who were so scared on that day. It was in defense of myself because I felt my life was in danger, the circumstance that I found myself. That day, I thought I needed to have saved my life by defending my life there. But Mr. Chairman, I also want to plead with this committee that the issue is before the police for investigation. I wouldn't want to say much about it.
The sector minister was hilariously questioned on the definition of fish farming.
I'll try my best. Fish farming is the process of rearing of fish in the reservoirs and the fish ponds, etc. Thank you.
And some advantages. I think OBMO is just disturbing.
Said, what are some advantages of a fish farming? Honourable Member, please, I said, what are the advantages of fish farming?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. One advantage of fish farming is it makes the farmer earn some income. It also increases fish in our community for consumption.
She touched on the impact of plastics on fishing.
I think it all bows to our environment, how to keep the environment clean. So in collaboration with the stakeholders at the fishing community and in consultation with the sanitation ministry and the relevant agencies, we'll discuss how to get rid of these plastics in our seas. And also, as I earlier on mentioned, we will also encourage the fishermen to use the right gears for the fishing. That is not supposed to maybe bring in these plastics out from the sea when they go for the fishing. When they use the right fishing gear, it's likely to save them from getting the plastics.
The minister nominee for information, Kojo Opon Nkrumah, appeared next. He spoke about the rate of attacks on journalists in the country.
Whenever you hear of a report, or whenever I hear of a report that a journalist has been attacked, in my mind, one of three things is most likely happening. First, it may be true. And there are instances in which it is true that this person has been attacked in his line of work of journalism. Then there are instances where it is false. It's a totally cooked up story. And then there are instances where it is a coincidence. Somebody may have been attacked. That person happens to be a journalist, but it has absolutely nothing to do with his work as a journalist. So for example, Chairman, if you recall, I think in 2006, if my memory is right, my colleague, Efiapokua, and a couple of others, and this is a matter of public record, they went to the courts, the human rights courts ruled on it, went to NHIA to cover a story, and they were attacked by people because of the work they were doing. So that is a clear instance where it has happened. Then you can have instances where, again, if I take you back to about 2007, you'll recall the case of the Palava newspaper, Mr. Jojo Buskwansa, subject of a court ruling and the matters that came and the story that he had been abducted, found with blood, etc. Later, the police wanted to charge him for deceit of a public officer. It turned out that That was not true. But it had been reported that a journalist was under attack. So that is an instance in which the report comes, but it's false. And then you can have coincidence. For example, Samuel Kwabena Ini, Ashanti Regional DJ, I think president at the time, between February and April 2007, shot in a bar. And initially the report was, a journalist has been killed, suspected I was in his line of work. I think by April, the police had arrested the persons and it was because of armed robbery and proceeded to charge them and get a conviction accordingly. So anytime you hear or I hear of an attack on journalists, my professional understanding is that one of three things must be happening. So what did we do? We realized that one of the first things that needs to happen is to have the reports of attacks on journalists validated. Because as the reports go and nobody is investigating and validating, you would notice that over the years, our ranking on the World Press Freedom Index is coming down because all this chatter is picked online and it counts against us. So one of the first things we need to do is to validate. Another thing we need to do is to ensure that there's proper follow-up on whatever investigations are supposed to take place. And then we also need to provide the media with a lot of support and training on how they can also protect themselves or ensure they don't get into instances where they become the victims of attacks.
He also commented on the directions that the state broadcaster GBC is headed in terms of operations.
The board and management of Ghana Broadcasting Corporation itself was contemplating other options for generating revenue for GBC. And it was around that same time that the then Director General, my understanding is without full recourse to the board, wrote to the CJ to designate some courts. So the internal mechanism you need to push and pursue that was not necessarily forthcoming from within their own institution. But Chairman, I think we have a slightly different view of how funding that should go to GBC should take place. Under the DTT policy, we are looking at the Digital Access Fund and how monies from that fund, part of monies from that fund can be seeded to the public service broadcaster to make public service broadcasting more efficient. Because the arguments about who should pay TV license and who should not pay in contemporary times, I'm informed, does not find favor with a good number of stakeholders in the industry. So our view when we do get to that point will be to focus more on the Digital Access Fund. And I've been working, when I was Minister for Information, I was working with the then Minister of Communications on that project. My hope is that if you do pass me, we'll get back on it and move it forward.